Hi, today we are going to discuss about capacity planning in production and operations management. Our major points of discussion would be, we will be talking what capacity planning is, what are the strategic decisions that one takes about capacity, how the capacity is measured, what is the licensed, installed and rated capacity, what are the influences on the effective capacity. Then we will solve an example of capacity planning and then we will summarize our discussion. The determination of capacity and adjustment of capacity to meet fluctuations in demand is one of the key problems faced by the production planning and control. Capacity decisions have direct influence on performance of the production system in respect to both resource productivity and customer service. Excess capacity results in low resource productivity, while inadequate capacity leads to poor customer service. If you have excess capacity, more capacity than you require, then the productivity of your resources would be less. It is implied. However, if you have inadequate capacity and you have to produce more, then the customer service would suffer because you will not be able to deliver the customer the product in time and as per the requirement. So capacity planning is basically concerned with matching the resources with demand. A stable demand makes the task of capacity planning simple. Ideally, we would like a stable demand, but we don't live in a perfect world. So there are fluctuations in demand, and fluctuations in demand basically create problem concerning the acquisition of resources and matching them up to the demand levels. So here the task becomes complicated if the demand fluctuations are there. The strategic decisions regarding capacity are following questions. If you can answer, then the decisions can be found taken, and the questions are: what is the expected growth of the industry and company share of the market? How accurate is the company's prediction of the market? Should capacity planning be based on optimistic or pessimistic scenario? Should capacity be created at one location or multiple locations? How many shifts should company run each day, and number of working days a company should work in a week? What percentage of company's requirement can be met by resorting to subcontracting? Subcontracting is you increase your capacity by subletting some of your work. What is the company policy for meeting shortfalls in capacity? That is related to overtime and holiday working, because that gives you excess capacity. Capacity measurement is different for different kind of products. If the products are homogeneous, then it is measured in units per unit of time, and the examples can be automobile, thousands of vehicles per month, steel, tons of steel per year, in textile mill, millions of meter of cloth per year, in thermal power plant you use megawatts of power. If the product are of multiple types, then it is usually measured in labor hours or machine hours, and or the limiting resources that you have, they define the capacity. In job shop you mention the capacity in labor hours or machine hours. In hospitals, the limiting resource is bed, so bed days per month are defines the capacity. Consultancy firm, consultation days per year. So this is how capacity measurement is done in different kind of industry. When the capacity is limited, how do you overcome the limited capacity? Limited capacity to a certain extent can be overcome by these following things: working extra day a week or additional shift a day, resorting to overtime work, strengthening the weakest link, that is increasing the capacity of the bottleneck. We can increase the overall production and increase the capacity by increasing the capacity of the bottleneck. Also, if we invest in balancing equipment, we can increase the capacity of the production line. Subcontracting is also a way of increasing the capacity. Capacities of three types: licensed capacity, installed capacity and rated capacity. Licensed capacity is the capacity that is licensed by the concerned government authorities, that this much you are allowed and authorized to produce. Installed capacity is the capacity that is installed at the time of installation. So initially, in the ideal circumstances, this is the installed capacity. Rated capacity is basically the highest production rate that was actually established in reality in the plant, that is rated capacity. These are the major factors which influence on the effective capacity: demand forecast, labor efficiency, plant efficiency, multiplicity of shifts, subcontracting and management policies. We will deal with this one by one. Demand forecast. Now there are factors which influence the forecast. Forecast is basically the projection for the future. So forecasting is affected by life cycle of the product. Products with very long life cycle usually exhibit steady demand and growth compared to product with short life cycle. Forecast can be made with greater confidence for the product with long product life cycle. For example, sugar, cement, fertilizer, textile, steel, they have a long product life cycle. Forecasting also depends on the product phase in which the product is. Products in the maturity phase compared to the product in growth phase show less fluctuation in demand. So forecasting in the product phase is easier compared to the forecasting in the growth phase. Forecasting in maturity phase is easier than the forecasting in growth phase, because in maturity the graph is more or less constant. The forecasting also depends on the number of products. A firm manufacturing large number of products generally experiences less fluctuation in total demand than the firm manufacturing one product. For example, an automobile firm manufacturing one brand of bike is more susceptible to the environmental conditions than the one producing more brands, because overall the demand remains constant. If there is a high demand for one kind of product, then there is a low demand for other kind of product, and vice versa is also true. Labor efficiency against output standard. Output standard are set by industrial engineering department considering average operator and normal pace of working. All operators do not meet standard, even if the standard are equitable. Apprentice and old workmen simply are not able to meet the standard. There are deliberate slackers, bossy and organized class, which set their own standard. So in lieu of substandard performance, requirement of man and machine hours required to be corrected by dividing the standard hours by the labor efficiency. If a total of 400 hours are required per month, then we need an equivalent of 400 divided by 80%, considering that the labor efficiency is 80%. It is very difficult to find the labor efficiency at 100% because of the factors that we have discussed earlier. Labor efficiency changes from machine to machine and company to company. Plant efficiency is also one of the factors that affects capacity planning. It considers enforced idle time of the machine because of scheduling delays, machine breakdown, preventive maintenance, etc. Plant efficiency factor varies from equipment to equipment and company to company. These usually range from 50% to 95%. For example, if a total 600 grinding machine hours are required per month, then we need an equivalent of 600 divided by 80% is equal to 750 hours if the plant efficiency factor is 80%. The plant efficiency factor can be established by PPC either by estimation or by conducting work sampling studies. Multiplicity of shifts is also a determining or defining factor for the capacity planning. It implies the number of shifts that the firm should run on each day. Single shift increases investment, while multiple shift increases labor cost and supervision cost. Wage premium equivalent to 20 to 25% is common for third shift. Productivity is low in second shift and much lower in third shift, while losses due to defective are higher in multiple shifts. Multiple shifts are economical for industries which are large and have capital investment in making the plant or the machinery. And the examples of these kind of industry are steel industry, chemical industry, oil refineries, and other having large investment in building and equipment per workman. Single or double shifts are desirable in industries which have low capital investment per workman. Subcontracting is also a factor by which the capacity can be increased. The process of offloading some of firm's manufacturing requirements to outside vendors to design peculiar to the firm for economic reasons. Most convenient and the fastest method of meeting the firm's investment and labor cost at the minimum. The decision to subcontract must be backed by the systematic and careful cost analysis. Comparison between the make cost and the buy cost, make or buy analysis is to be done if it is economical to make the product, if it is economical to buy the product by subcontracting. Management policies also are the important factor for capacity planning. Some policies which affect capacity planning decisions are not to invest in machines where subcontracting is possible, to perform critical operations which are liable for rejection at home plant, to restrict multiple shifts to two except for the equipment which involve heavy capital investment, to run semi-automatic, automatic and other equipment devoid of possibility of rejection on three shift basis, to buy another machine as soon as the utilization of existing machine exceeds the prefix figure, say 80% on two shift basis. Not to consider for availability those machines which are functionally degraded. To maintain sufficient inventory of spares for the machine to which no substitute are available. These are few examples of management policies that we follow. This management policy, based on that we will have the capacity planning. For example, as a management policy, if you only work in two shifts, instead of getting a third shift, we will procure the machine and equipment and install a new plant to increase our capacity instead of third shift. So that is a management policy that is decided at the corporate level and it is implemented by the production planning people who take care of capacity planning. Let us take an example of capacity planning. Table below gives the standard time of sawing off operation of different jobs being processed at job order production unit. Table also gives average monthly requirement of each indicated item. So part number is given, standard time per piece in minutes is given, average quantity per month is given. This is the question that estimates the requirement of power hacksaws and manpower for the above mentioned production targets. Assume the necessary data after stating the reason for the assumptions. If presently the company has 4 power hacksaws, establish an additional requirement. It is given that there are 4 hacksaws and you have to see how many additional hacksaws will be required after calculation. The company has received an order of new item to be produced from the bar stock in lots of 2000 numbers per month. The standard time required for to show off each part of this item is estimated to be 12 minutes. What will be the total requirement of machines and manpower now? Should the company accept the order or regret considering 6 power hacksaws being available? So there are two parts to this question. First, if 4 power hacksaws are available, if we have additional requirement. Second, there are additional requirement of 2000 pieces and here there are 6 hacksaws available. Do we need additional for honoring the order or should we send a regret? So these are the assumptions that we make when we solve the question. One is the labor efficiency against output standard is 75%. The plant utilization to allow delay and interruption is 80%. Multiplicity of shift is restricted to double shift only. We are not using third shift. Hours available per machine per month on 2-hour basis is 400. Based on above assumptions, we shall make a table to solve the problem. So column 1 is serial number, column 2 is part number, column 3 is the standard time that is given, column 4 is the average requirement time, column 5 is the indicated capacity, that will be the multiplication of standard time per piece multiplied by average required per month. Equipment running hours of 75%, equipment running hours would be 75% of 400, and then 80% capacity hours would be 80% of 400. And machines required on this basis would be basically total number of required quantity divided by your equipment efficiency. So 1676 divided by 235 is 0.73. So you need 0.73 machines. Similarly, this is how you make the table and do the calculation. So total requirement of equipment come out, if you add all the machines required on the two shift basis, the total requirement would come out to be 6.18, that would be 6. So capacity available is 4 numbers, so you, if you less the capacity generated by subcontracting, as such we are not subcontracting anything in this question, so the net requirement would be 2 numbers. The second part of the question says that the additional machine required for the job if 75% labor efficiency and 80% plant utilization, so this would be calculated using this formula, standard time per piece into monthly requirement, that would be 12 into 12,000. Labor efficiency divided by labor efficiency into plant efficiency into hours available per month. So hours available is 400, labor efficiency is 0.75, this efficiency is 0.80, and 60 is the number of minutes in an hour. So we would need 1.67 numbers of additional machine. So previous load is 6.18, we need 1.67 for the fresh load, so we need 8 machines. If 6 machines are available with us, then we would need 2 machines, and till the time we get 2 machines, we can complete the additional requirement by an additional shift. So we should not send a regret for this. Thank you for your time, people.